We give X5s to our baby mamas. Someone placed that in my comment section when I put up the picture of an X5 and the Porsche in my garage. And it's a lyric from a rap song. And the person was like scratching my head, like I was supposed to know that rap song. Well, here's the thing. Rappers are not my role models, or they're not the people I aspire to be like, because I know that there are many people, you know, A.G. Gaston, Reginald Lewis, there are many professional black people that became multimillionaires by running businesses. Those are my role models, not rappers, not the rapper lifestyle, not knowing these lyrics. I know that some people have invested so much time, effort, and energy into rap. You've got 40-year-old people who are still trying to be put on for their rap career. And for me, I feel that there's a better way. Jay-Z is not my role model. I mean, yeah, he's made a lot of money. He's married to Beyonce. Big whoop. That does nothing for me. It does not put air into my day. I'm glad he's successful. I hope he's happy. But I'm not part of the rap, ghetto, hood, hip hop culture, because I feel that that culture is corrosive to success. And only how many Jay-Z's do we have? We got Jay-Z, we got Kanye. Who else do we have on that level? Who else? There's only a really small percentage of them that make it to the mega level of success. Dr. Dre, Ice Cube. We don't really have that many. The average rapper is broke or close to broke. And once again, this is not like part of me. Like, I like to listen to some nice jazz. I like to listen to some music. Because when I was going through my reformation, transformation process, I used to listen to Baroque classical music because that enables you to study at a higher level. I just don't have a use for rap. I really don't care about it. Every now and then, there'll be something that'll come out that's kind of hot, that's kind of nice. But as a norm, I don't have a bunch of rap playing up in my house. I have a totally different taste. I'm listening to old school Prince. I'm listening to even older school Percy Sledge. I'm not listening to rap, which is skirt, skirt, whatever that's about. I'm not listening to it. And also, there are many people who aspire to be like these rappers. They have this rapper type lifestyle of making a lot of money, driving fast cars, having fast women, and just living that life and smoking a little bud and weed. That's not my life. I really don't care about rappers. I don't care about what rappers do. I don't know who is the current rapper. O'Shea Duke Jackson did something about Meg Thee Stallion. I'm like, who and what is that? I don't really care about those people because I'm too busy living my little happy life. I live in a nice big house. I drive a Porsche. I make a lot of money. I'm having fun being me. I have no reason to aspire to be like a rapper. I am too busy creating the collective cool of Cameron. What I do is cool. What I make is cool. That's the whole goal. I'm not trying to emulate someone who has elevated and capitalized and packaged hood culture and is selling it. I have no use for that. None whatsoever. Because it's just sitting there like, and you know, I get this all the time, like someone would lace up a rap lyric like, I'm supposed to know, I don't know all these. And also, to the person who said we give the X5s to our baby mamas, you can't afford an X5 and you can't pay your child support. How about that? Catch me outside, player. You know, it's just this whole notion of I'm a very mentally strong person. And I don't let other people define what's good for me. I have a red X5M, which is fast. I like it. That was a choice that I made. And I don't care if you like, well, if it was me, I would. Well, I'm not you. I'm me. I'm doing me. I'm doing me very well. I'm doing me better than you or you doing yourself, because I'm happy. I have joy in my life. Every morning I wake up, I get to do something I want to do. I don't have to go to some suck job. I don't have to deal with a situation of dealing with people I don't like. I don't have any of that. I have my own little bubble that I exist in and I have fun in. So I don't need to be told that I should be like, you know, what's her, Nicki Minaj. I forget the new one. She used to be a stripper. She used to be Cardi B. I'm not part of that culture. I don't appreciate that culture. I don't subscribe to that culture. And I'm not going to be told that's what I need to do in order to be successful. Just like I said again, I'm a strong-willed, strong-minded person, and I don't need anyone to tell me what success is or what success isn't, nor to define what I should do or tell me what kind of car. Like, if I wanted a Lamborghini, there would be a Lambo in the garage. I've ridden in a few of them. They ride terrible. It's a harsh ride. It's a beautiful car if it's fancy, but if I wanted one, I would have one. The reason I don't have one is I don't want one. What's in my garage is what I want. I'm old enough, smart enough to make my own decisions and not to be influenced by social media. This is one of the things that I want to impart to you in terms of grown man methodology, that you get to a certain place in life where you choose what you want to choose. I have a friend. She's extremely nice. She is super cool. And he actually had, because see, if you're my friend and you're married, your wife is your wife. I'm not going to say anything. Because the thing is, from an appearance perspective, she's somewhat plain. And my friend is very rich. And he actually had people step to him and say, like, why'd you end up with her? And he said, because I love this woman. See, I come from a time where if a man married a woman that was his wife, you respected that. Regardless if you would have did it or not, you respected it. And you would never step to that man and like, why'd you marry her? He actually told me that some of our mutual friends actually said that to him. And well, I should say former friends, because he stopped talking to him after that. Because when you get into grown man methodology, you pick and choose what you like. You're not a kid, you're not a child, you're not in high school, so no one else decides what's good for you, what's not good for you. And my friend who's married to this, because like I said, I think she's cute, my opinion. And you know, they have a good marriage, he's happy. That's what should matter. But right now, in this hip hop rap culture, you gotta have this kind of chick, you gotta have this kind of car, you need to have this kind of fit. It's childish, it is stupid. And you are not an individual. You are being led around like a little child with a ring in your nose based upon this hip hop rap culture. Like I said, Jay-Z is not my role model. A.G. Gaston, Reginald Lewis, Washington Carver, Kenneth Chenault, who's the CEO of American Express. Those are my role models. Men who've gone out and made millions of dollars, built businesses, and were respectable. We're respectable. And that's the whole thing, because like this whole deal with the rappers, this is why I speak out so harshly against hood ghetto culture, because it is corrosive to success. Because for you to embrace that culture, you have to reject, quote, European culture. And let me just say it here for a buck. If you were born here in America, you are an American. You're not an African American, because your originality, your roots may have come from Africa. But you were born in the United States of America, which makes you an American citizen. And when you go to Africa, you will be treated like an American, because that's what you are. You're not an African American, you're an American. And there are so many people who don't want to embrace that because, well, you know, I don't want to be doing what the Europeans be doing. That's the situation. That's where we are. And these are not European ways, these are the ways to become successful in America. Actually, that's what your boy Jay-Z is doing. Jay-Z has taken hood culture, packaged it up, and commercialized it and sold it. He's being very European by doing that. But you don't see that because you like, yeah, Jay cool, Jay married to Beyonce, blah, 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 blah. You can't even see it because you don't even know the game. Ice Cube, Dr. Dre, they were not hood kids. They figured that, hey, this hood stuff, I can package it up, I can sell it, and I can make a lot of money, and that's what they did. That's called capitalism, which is very European. Well, actually, if you knew your history and you would go back to the Moors in Africa, who were merchants, traders, and warriors who used to do business with the Europeans and taught the Europeans some stuff, if you know your history, you will know that doing that behavior and conducting yourself in that manner is very, very much African. Very much so, at a high level. But we got people who are embracing this hood, ghetto, crap culture, worshiping rappers, going around here saying rap lyrics as everybody should know them, versus sitting down, focusing, and starting a business. Also, I just did my first live of the Money Show and it went really, really well. I almost had like 200 people. So that was really good for that y'all, because I've done live streams on this channel and I only had 130 people. So I had 200 people climbing, and the Money Show is going to happen once or twice a week. I'm not going to do them every day, but I really enjoyed it. And you know, there was a great audience. They were asking really good questions, and we only had a few yard birds. We had 2 yard birds. Someone told me, I don't have a Porsche. I don't have 9 streams of income. I'm just out here pretending. Jealousy is so distasteful. Jealousy is so ugly. But overall, I would give the show an A+, and I enjoy doing it. And what's gonna happen is Savage Finance is gonna become what I tried to do over here. Because, you know, now that I have new YouTube knowledge, be sure to get the YouTube course if you want to start YouTube and start selling stuff and making money on YouTube. Link should be below. If it's not, it's on My Life on the Tube. Oh man, the things that are going to happen, the things that we're going to do this year are so inspiring, and they're so awesome, because Savage Finance is probably going to get to 10,000 subscribers and it's only 6 months old. You know how long it took me to get to 10,000 subscribers on this channel? Almost 3 years. 3 years. And I was putting up a lot of videos. So that, you know, for me, in my perspective, that's shown how much I have grown as a content creator. And with this new swag and new mastermind stuff I got, it's going to be good, because I'm really enjoying the show. So if you haven't checked it out, go to Savage Finance. Check out The Money Show. I got a new studio, which is lit. I'm having fun. And this is more grown man methodology. See, I'm doing what I'm doing. Like, there's a video on Savage Finance that's called 401ks are garbage. And I have people who have not sat down and wrote out the math. Because the guy was like, well, I'm doing these kind of swing trades and stuff with my Roth IRA. And I was like, what happens once you get past your contribution limit? See, I set him up, because you can only, I think you can only live to contribute $5,500 or $6,500 per year. And you can't make that much money off a contribution of $6,500 or $5,500 per year. You just can't. Even if you were to double your return, which ain't happening, that's only gonna be like $10,000 to $12,000. The fastest way to get real money is to start a business. And I've been saying that for the last 10 years. And you know, I have all these people, and this is something else too. And I want you guys to listen to me, and listen to me really well. You need to focus. He's got a Roth IRA, he's got this other stuff, he's got real estate. This is what I call the appearance of looking successful. I'm doing this, I'm doing this, I'm doing this. The most successful people I know typically focus on a few things and do them extremely well. I am not, like, I don't have a 401k. I do have a Roth. I just stopped contributing to it. And, you know, with Savage Finance, I'm going to give you guys sound money principles. You will not be put in a weird or strange or compromised position. I think that kind of happened to some people with this Tulsa fund. I don't really know, but I'm not going to do that to you. I'm not going to mislead you or lie to you, because I'm going to give you the same financial principles that enabled me to pay cash for a Porsche. Now, there are many of you that heard that. It's like, he paid cash for a Porsche. Let me listen to this dude. And for you people, you good people, you kind-hearted people, you respectful people who enjoy the live streams, I appreciate you. Now, for you knuckleheads who, oh, he ain't buy no Porsche, get out your feelings. Get out your feelings. There is a Porsche in the garage. There's a BMW in the garage. And there will be many, many things, more things that are coming, because the principles that I'm giving you are based upon cash flow and creating a cash flow system. My retirement will be funded by rental real estate. I'm not gonna do a 401k. I'm gonna do, my goal is to get 25 properties in the next 10 years. So that's gonna be 3 to 4 a year. Once I get those 25 properties, I may start flipping property. Why would I start flipping property? Because at 25 properties, I'm gonna have about $50,000 to $60,000 a month cash flow. So if I go ahead and get myself in a situation where I'm flipping the property and it goes long, I'm not hurt. See, this is the whole thing. And this is why having a, you know, because I'm gonna do a masterclass on the real estate thing. I gotta sit down and talk to my CPA. Got to get make sure that this is gonna work the way that I envision it's gonna work in my head. But man, we're gonna do some beautiful things. So to the beautiful people, to the good loving people, the kind, respectful people who support this channel and Savage Finance, I say thank you. And to you idiots who just want attention, I have some advice for you. Grow up, get out your feelings, sit down, or I got a rap lyric for you from Outkast. Get up, go out, and get something. How about that? How about you do that and stay out my business? Go out and get you some business of your own and stay out my business, AKA Greg Murray. Yeah, I see you. Well, that's right. You can't come in on Savage Finance and you can't come in on Life in the Tube because I blocked you because you are you're fundamentally stupid. You're an idiot. You're so busy looking at what I'm doing. Your whole life must suck. It must absolutely suck. I know you're gonna see this because you watch everything I do. Like that song, Maxwell, I feel like somebody's watching me. You're just a misguided fan. So that's all I got for you guys. Go below, get 30 days for $2,500. Go below, get the Hustler's Mindset, Pimp Your Mind for Success. Go below and get the Oxygen Banking app and take the money that you make from 30 days to $2,500 and start stacking it in that personal account. Wednesday, I'm gonna have another Oxygen Bank review. So look for that, because I got some things I wanna say, because some stuff kind of happened last week and I'm gonna talk about it. So that's all I got. It's off my chest. See you guys in the next video.